Good evening to all the participants. I welcome you on behalf of Madras to this very special program today, where we are going to felicitate our very own pride of Madras Kaspa, Mr. N. Venkatraman, who has been appointed as the additional advocate, additional Solicitor General of India Supreme Court. So thank you once again for all joining us. Before we start the session, I request Mr. A.P. Srinivasa to kindly tell a few words, and thereafter the session shall continue. Thank you.
Today we are assembled here to felicitate the additional Solicitor General of India, Supreme Court, Senior Mr. Venkatraman. I request Mr. G. Narajan to conduct the proceedings.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Srinivas. I thought Mr. Venkatraman is a very great devotee of Sringeri Math and Sharada Bidam. I thought I will set that Sharada Bidam as my background today. So that will be a fitting tribute to welcome him to our session. So before we start, today's session is going to be, we will start with A.P. Srinivas reading out a congratulatory message on behalf of all of us from the Madras Tax Bar. And after that, I will take the proceedings.
Yes, sir. That honor is, and privilege.
I am engaging with the company in four parts. Yes, Mr. Srinivas and Mr. Mehman of Madras Bar will start. Over to PS.
Yes. It's a honor and privilege conferred on me. Yes, sir. Am I audible?
APS, sir, you are audible, sir.
Yes.
Natarajan, sir, has some audio issues. I will check with that. You can continue.
Is my audio proper, Prithvi?
Yes, sir.
Okay. APS, you can start with your message on behalf of MTB, and then we will continue with the session. Over to APS. APS? Prithvi, am I audible?
You are audible. Sir,
okay.
I'm just checking with APS, sir. We can start, sir.
It's a honor and privilege conferred on me to have this gifted opportunity to felicitate Senior Advocate Mr. N. Venkatraman, who would be donning the role of Additional Solicitor General of India in the Honorable Supreme Court of India. It is indeed a proud moment for the Madras Tax Bar to host this exclusive session, as he is the son of the soil of this Madras Tax Bar. Briefly captured, Senior Advocate Mr. N. Venkatraman is an epitome of simplicity in personal and public life, devotion to the legal profession, and dedication to the society at large, a virtue which would remain as an illuminating footnote to the generations to come. His unassuming nature had always captured everyone around, and he had been a role model and mentor to many young thugs of this Madras Tax Bar. Here I want to quote the one article written in Tax Scan on the appointment of Mr. N. Venkatraman as Additional Solicitor General India. So he is the youngest advocate at the age of 39 to confer on the senior advocate status, and he almost appeared in all the 23 high courts and as well as in Supreme Court, and he is our Manikam of Madras Tax Bar. On behalf of the Madras Tax Bar, with a deep sense of pride and honor, I heartily congratulate the senior and wish him all success with good health in his new avatar as the Additional Solicitor General of India.
Thank you, yes, Mr. Srinivas.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Senior Advocate, sir.
Thank you, APS. Thank you so much.
Thank you, friends. Thank you, APS. So how we are going to have this session today, as you may be aware. Prithvi, am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So how we are planning to have this session, as we have already communicated in the group, it is not like Mr. Venkatraman feels that let it not be a session where there will be only some congratulatory speeches and felicitation speeches, which may be a little embarrassing for him. And as always, he wanted to convey a message through this session. So he will not waste any opportunity to convey a message, especially to the younger generations of the bar. Those of us who have attended the 100th webinar of MTB, we all heard Justice Vinit Kothari saying that, see, whatever be the problems that is plaguing our country, take for example, corruption. Can we eradicate corruption in a period of next 3 years or next 5 years? It may be impossible. Any problem in this world or in our country, we can solve it only if you target the next generation. Because the current generation is so engrossed in the problems, so it will be very, very difficult to bring them back to a stream. But if you target the younger generation, if you catch the people young and teach them the proper values, definitely, at least during the next generation, we will have a society without any of these evil practices. So that way, Mr. Venkatraman has always been targeting the audience. So today's session is also like that. So how we are planning to have it, I will be interacting with Mr. NV in a four-part session on four important aspects, which will be relevant not only for the youngsters, but all of us. And in between the four parts, I will also from our whoever has been attending session to talk a few words about their association with Mr. NV and other aspects of it. So with this, I will just move on with the session. I hope Mr. NV is also comfortable with this particular format. Now, to borrow from APS, since APS is always known for telling Thirukkural, I said that to borrow from APS. Actually, to borrow from the words of the great Thiruvalluvar, Kaatchi Keliyan, Kadunjollan Allanel, Meekoorum Mannan Nilan. This is a Thirukkural under that Adhigaram Irai Maatchi to tell how a king should be. The same Thirukkural will equally apply for all senior advocates, and not only for senior advocates, all advocates in our profession also. Kaatchi Keliyan, one who is accessible to everybody without any problem. Kadunjollan Allanel, who talks very softly, who does not use any harsh words. He will be the best king in the world, and he will be the best senior advocate, and he will be the best advocate also. We have come across few advocates and few, where dealing with a senior advocate will be a real exercise where we used to have a lot of fear. We will not be having much of a time. Within some 5-10 minutes, we may have to give the briefing, and we may have to put up with their harsh reactions also. But fortunately, many of the seniors from this profession are not like that, and Venkatraman is also one of them. And it is this particular quality which has endeared him both among the juniors as well as among the associate community. And whoever has got the opportunity to move with him will vouch for this particular quality. Secondly, as I said in the beginning, his approach, his concern about the youth of the country, and whatever he does, whatever he speaks, he has been interacting with a lot of college students. He will have a message, and he has taken the mantle of guiding the youth in proper perspective. And rightly, today also, we will be having that as a format. So today, what we are going to do, there are four Qs. Today, we are going to address this particular session on four Qs. Q. The first Q is going to be the intelligent quotient, the IQ. For any person, and especially for any advocate, the IQ forms a major component. The IQ, a major part of the IQ, is a blessing. It has to come from birth, a major part of it. A part of it can be achieved through proper education. A part of it can be achieved from learning through the surroundings. The people with whom you are moving, the industrialists, the other advocates, the judges. So like that, from the people who are surrounded and with whom you are moving, they are capable of imparting great knowledge on you. The second part is the role of a senior or the role of a guru. I will come to that little later. So first, the first important cue for the success of anybody And especially people like Mr. Venkatraman, who has achieved a lot of things. The first senior who has become the senior at the age of 39. And perhaps he may be the junior most person to be designated as the ASG in Supreme Court also. We may have to check that aspect also. So in this particular situation, I request Mr. N.V. to share his thoughts. What is the importance of IQ for this particular profession especially? And what is his advice to the younger generation? How to enrich one's IQ, the first Q, the intelligent quotient. Your views on that, Mr. N.V.
Vivekinam mahapragyam dairyodara kshamanidhim sadabhinava purvam tam vidyatheertha gurum bhaje ajnanam jahnavi teertham vidyatheertham vivekinam sarvesham sukatam teertham bharati teertham ashraye Vidya Vinaya Sampannam Vitaragam Vivekinam Vande Vedanta Tatvakyam Vidushekara Bharati. My dear MTB, my well wishes, few of my family members and two or three of my friends. I owe this evening to all of you. I'm so happy that MTB has taken my request quite seriously in ensuring the invitation doesn't go to anyone else and it is confined only to MTB and my family members and just three or four of my close well-wishers and friends. And I'm so thankful to all of you looking at the number that virtually each one of you has turned out today to those who are elders to bless me and those who are young to wish me. This matters a lot to me. Before I proceed to answer J. Natraj's question, I place this appointment at the lotus feet of my spiritual guru, the saints of Sringeri, and my professional guru, Mr. C. Natarajan. Now coming to the first question, the first part. I would like to say the following, which I have understood from working with important people in India, reading the biographies of a lot of successful people. I had the good opportunity to work with people like Mr. Mukesh Ambani, Mr. Manoj Modi, Mr. Asim Premji, Mr. Sethuraman Sir, the former Vice Chancellor of Shastra University, and a galaxy of people in 31 years. What has brought them to that scale? I think that is a lesson which we should impart to ourselves and more importantly to the next generation. These are the qualities I could observe in them closely. There may be many and each one perceives it differently, but this is what I have seen in them. One, we all know that one has to work, but how do they work? It's not just hard work. It is hard work unmindful of any results or consequences. They are worried about their work. They are worried about achieving that particular milestone through their effort as work, unmindful of their consequences. Now, what does this do to a human nature is, it does three things to them from what little I have observed. First of all, they become they are liked by people around them. It's an important quality, especially for a lawyer. You should be liked by the court. You should be liked by the client. You should be liked even by the opponent counsel. Before you become a successful lawyer, you should be liked. So take all these successful people. They are all liked. They may have their own adversaries. That's exceptional, but by nature. Two, if you like somebody, over a period of time, you will develop trust in that person. Trust is a very, very, very indispensable quotient in life. Unless people trust you, you cannot progress. These people have progressed because someone, an investor has trusted them. A set of shareholders has trusted them. The priorities in their life, putting before the boards, have trusted them. And trust is a very, very essential. It's a positive quality in a human being, which these people have acquired. Three, Once you develop a liking and a trust, this is the chemistry that happens to your human mind, which I've seen in all of them, is people start developing expectations. So trust, liking, and expectations together make you a very, very confident person and not an arrogant person. If you are trusted, and if you know that you are trusted, you will become less and less arrogant. It's only people who are suspicious, who do not trust others, are always people who are arrogant. This difference is so evident in anybody's life, which you can observe. But once you become confident, then life throws a lot of opportunities to you. This is what I've seen in all of them. And opportunities lead to success. And success leads to reputation. And reputation finally leads to recognition. So this is the path. You can read any biography in history, and you can watch anybody who is a living legend today in the world. Go and read their crux. These are the 6 or 7 steps which has brought them wherever they are. Therefore, all of us, especially our children, should learn these. This together forms the intelligent quotient. It is not simply brain power. So together, this forms IQ, according to me. Over to you, Natraj. Natraj?
Yeah, thank you, sir. Thank you for that insight. For acquiring IQ, being surrounded by people who can impart you such IQ is very, very important. You have emphasized it. And you have also given the message to the youngsters that we should read more and more of biographies of great people so that we can emulate that model. Now, as you know, the role of a senior plays a very important role in development of, especially in our profession. And we all know how much you rever your senior, Mr. C. Natarajan. And we have heard a lot from you. And you have, in fact, conducted a very grand function of Guru Vandanam also for him. So now I think it is the right time for you to recollect your association with the CN and what are all the lessons you have learned. And in the process, you can also tell these are all the lessons which today's youngsters can learn from their juniors. So I'll just move on to your senior. You can now talk about him, sir.
Yes. See, one should be fortunate to have good parents and equally or more fortunate to have good gurus. If these two things happen in life, then life is already made for you. I was blessed with both. I'll come to my parents and to my spiritual guru in the last section, but I'll talk about my professional guru here. See, our scriptures say, how should a guru and shishya be? And it says, in body and mind, they will be two. But over a period of time, the shishya should become the shadow of the guru. So shadow is what? It's your own reflection. So when you see your own shadow, it should appeal to you that it is, when the senior feels his own shadow, it should appeal to him that he is actually seeing his shishya. I do not know whether I have achieved that milestone in my life with my guru, but I was the most blessed because when he was in the peak of his career, I was closely associated with him, had the benefit of traveling with him to different places, and therefore spent the longest hours one-on-one. And I have given a set of 7 or 8 great qualities which he has imparted to me in my life, in my talk on the 50th session of the same MTB, when 5 great legends were spoken about, including my senior. His work ethics is uncomparable. His trust over clients, the trust clients had him, cannot be compared. He was one of the busiest lawyer and one of the costliest lawyer at that when he was in Chennai. But he would be working for a 5,000 rupees tax case for 3 days, burning the midnight oil, saying that it's an important proposition. After all, we make money, easy money somewhere else. So let's not give up our work in ensuring law gets settled rightly. He never chased anything in life. And especially he would say, never chase money or power or status. If you are destined, it'll come. If you're not destined, it's not going to come. So just concentrate on your work. And human compassion, if you say that I'm reasonably friendly with everybody, it has come only because of my senior. He is an epitome of human compassion. In fact, more than compassion, empathy. He will always first reflect what the other man needs. When he draws up a case, he'll find out whether a junior needs some money, and he will ensure his self-respect is not in any way distorted. So he'll involve him in a work, whatever may be his capacity, and ensure that his needs are first met before he takes the money to himself. Parting money is one of the richest quality we have seen it in our senior. Parting knowledge, there is no secrets, there is never a secrecy in our office. Everybody shared all the work together. So he was a phenomenal, Supreme Court has recognized him. His own written submission has become landmark judgments. So since I've spoken at length about him in that talk, I thought here I would repeat again. If a Shishya becomes the shadow of his guru, then he virtually becomes a guru. I'm yet to become that shadow. I only wish at some point of time I'm able to achieve that milestone. Over to you, Nataraj.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for the humility. Definitely you will be reaching more higher levels in your life with the blessings of your guru. So at this point, may I call upon from the audience. First, I will call Aparna Nandakumar, Senior Central Government Standing Council, to kindly join and share her acquaintances with Mr. NV and whatever she feels about the elevation of Mr. NV as ASG for India. So, Madam Aparna, Madam, can you join?
Yes,
okay.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Good evening, sir. Good evening, sir. Hearty congratulations and a very, very warm welcome to this side of the, you know, I would say the leeward side, not the
No. In fact, you are snatching him away from us.
Yes, but for the good, because the government needs a person like such a great person. He has, for the associates, he has given so much of relief and so much of help that the government needs him. And at the right moment, you have stepped in. Sir, you have been talking so much about trust and, the belief and all that. But two other qualities which I find is probably a USP of yours and the pinnacle of success that you are in are, number one, Guru Bhakti. Because I have never seen a program in which you have never ever referred to your guru, be it your spiritual guru or your professional. So that I think every youngster has to learn from you, because that Guru Bhakti is very important, not only in our profession, in any profession for that matter. That lead kindly light is a very, very important aspect to be a successful person, both material success as well as spiritual success. The other one which I find from you, sir, is that you are an epitome of humility. See, the first verse that you have recited before at the beginning of the program itself shows that you've learned that Vidya Dadati Vinayam. That is the first step. You have to be very, very humble. Whatever you learn, you've become a reservoir of knowledge and wisdom, not only because of your experiences with associates, with people around you, with the books that you have interacted with, but also because you are so humble and you still have the craving for learning. Sir, the experience which I had with you, I must really share a courtroom experience. In fact, I have, the youngsters use a word called stalking. I have been stalking you. I'm not feeling ashamed to admit it. In fact, I stalk you whatever you speak, wherever you speak, whatever decisions you have, you are involved in it. I have stalked you I have found your arguments immensely attractive, very unique, very original, very creative. However, in one courtroom experience, which I must admit, as a senior standing counsel, you had appeared in one matter. I think you will also remember just a few months back. You do not know the conflict of emotions that I went through. See, at one end, you are literally my hero. Of course, next to my Bhishma Pitamaha, Mr. Natarajan, nobody can replace him. But on the other hand, my duty is towards the government that I'm representing. Imagine the conflict of emotions that I'm undergoing. I did not know how to, but I wanted to do my best. See, the third emotion was, I'm facing a great senior. I have to do my best. And I did what I could. And in fact, sir, I won the case. I probably earned an enemy from you. But what could I do? I mean, that was a great experience for me. The other experience which I had was, I had a one-to-one talk. I think I had engaged you in one or two matters. And you gave me so much of audience, so much of, you know, I learned so much from you that I'm not able to enumerate each and everything. But what, I would say, you know, the mentors make you. And probably one of the mentors that have made me, I will certainly learn one thing from you, humility and Guru Bhakti. Two things, Guru Bhakti and definitely humility. I don't have anything much to say, sir. Thank you very much.
I'm very thankful to you, Aparna. And like you, I will share one experience I had with, see how trustworthy you, Hema, Hemalata, APS, all the said Baswami, every standing council. I'll just narrate only one experience. Hema Murli Krishnan engaged me one matter in sales tax. It was item 4 in the court. He was by my side, briefing me, and we got a stay. Item 11 was an income tax matter, and she was opposing me. My God, she ripped me as she used to do anybody. The kind of commitment and the kind of trust, the matter of, this trust is very important for every young junior. A learned judge, simply, the way she appreciated Hema Murli Krishnan in the open court is something Hema will always remember it as one of the best recognitions in our life. This is the trust. You should sweat yourself for your client. Not minding the fact that you just briefed a senior 10 minutes before. You have to take on him if he's going to oppose you. This is something which we have enjoyed with each one of you, and I'm thankful for the talk. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. From serial number 4 to serial number 7, how a person can transform himself or herself. And that is the quality of our government councils. And we are that, I should also say, this webinar series has helped me a lot in developing far more camaraderie among the associate councils and the revenue councils. That is the positive aspect of it. So now, to continue, before we continue with your the next queue, may I also call upon Dr. Vaidya Subramaniam, whom we heard yesterday also, and who is a good friend of Mr. NV, to kindly join and share his acquaintances with Mr. NV. So Mr. Vaidya, sir.
Thank you, Mr. Natarajan, and thank you very much, the organizers, for giving me this opportunity. In fact, I came to know just before the start of the meeting that I should also be sharing a few words on this wonderful occasion. So it's good that, you know, such notices come in a very short span of time, because for faculty like us who don't believe in any return speech, anything that resides at the top of our mind comes out first. And as human beings, what stays at the top of our mind is something that is always close to our heart. So on that count, the appointment of Senior Advocate Mr. N. Venkatraman as the Additional Solicitor General for India is definitely something that not only the Madras Tax Bar, but also all those who have been closely associated with him, both professionally as well as at other personal levels, is something that we feel so proud. And I must first congratulate him on this new assignment and wish him well. And I don't know the time limit that you have given, but it's better for faculty, teaching faculty like us, as much as for advocates like you, we are given a time limit, but I will just talk for just 3 minutes. I just want to share three things.
Sure.
As the previous speaker mentioned, I have never seen any speech from Mr. N. Venkatraman without offering vandanams to the venerated acharyas of Sringeri. He is a person who has devoted his life for a very noble cause, guided by the Sringeri acharyas, for the simple reason that he very strongly believes in our Sanatana Dharma. And I just went through the screen panel of this session, saw a lot of familiar faces that attended the session that we conducted to celebrate the 90th birthday of the legendary jurist Sri K. Parasaran, where he mentioned that Dharma and Satya are two eyes of justice. That is why you have Satyameva Jayate in the Madras High Court and Yatho Dharma Tatho Jayaha in the Supreme Court. And I see Mr. N. Venkatraman as somebody who can uphold both Satya and Dharma in discharge of his new duty as the ASG for India. The second is, just before we all assembled, we were discussing whether he will be the first person from the Madras Tax Bar to hold an office of this type. And his research said yes, he is the first person for the Madras Tax Bar. And he continues to follow the line of some of the stalwarts who left from Madras to occupy such posts in Delhi, some of whom we have already known. Mr. Parasaran, Mr. G. Ramaswamy, Mr. Gopal Subramanyam, Mr. K.K. Venugopal, Mr. Mohan Parasaran. All of these are the ones who left the Madras bar to decorate the posts in Delhi and went on to sit in higher posts. So I wish the same happens to Mr. N. Venkatraman, who was stepping into the corridors of Delhi as the ASG for India, only to get elevated further as the SG, AG, or even the Supreme Court judge, and that day is not very far. Thirdly, I'm extremely happy as the Vice Chancellor of Shastra and on behalf of the entire Shastra family that somebody who's closely associated with Shastra is now the ASG for India. To be very honest with you, I have always invited Mr. N. Venkatraman to come and address the student audience at Shastra Law School, and never has he said no. He has accepted my invitation and took his time off from his professional busy schedule to make it a point to address the younger generation on a variety of topics. And I think he has scanned almost a very diverse set of topics, and I am sure the student community also benefited a lot. Even before he became the ASG for India, I requested that he also join us as an adjunct faculty, because moving forward, we are going to have a lot of online sessions. And he very readily accepted. And after his acceptance came this very good news. And now I am very happy that amidst the Shastra faculty team, we have the ASG for India as an adjunct faculty for the Shastra School of Law. So I'm very happy on that count as well. So I wish Mr. N. Venkatraman a very long and successful professional endeavor at the Supreme Court. And I have no doubt that higher positions await him, because he is a person who is capable of decorating such higher positions to emerge as the jewel in the crown there. In fact, Tamil Solana, Poranda Vitland, we are sending him to Delhi. So, Poranda Vittu Perumaya, Kandipa, he will go and uphold it there. So, people there will realize the value of the Madras Tax Bar. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. So, we will now move on to the second queue. That is the emotional quotient. And this photo might have triggered your old memories, the time you got married. So, the emotional quotient also plays a very important role in the success of any person. So there has to be a proper balance in the emotional quotient. Too much of it may spoil somebody, or a lack of it also may spoil the relationship. There has to be a proper balance of emotional quotient life. So what is the contribution of this emotional quotient for the success of any person in his family? So you may kindly share your experience with us, sir.
Sure. Here again, even though I may quote my family, it applies to every Indian traditional family. And my request to youngsters is, please respect marriage and please respect family. Both these institutions are the two legs on which Indian ethos actually stand. But for the family, you think of yourself, whatever I say, you verify it with your own facts, it'll match. It'll match 100%. Without our sisters and brothers, would we have reached this scale? The kind of care, I'm the fifth child in my family, and first to four handheld me at my early days to bring me up to this level. And now my parents are not there, which I said, I'll mention it finally. My brother, who is elder to me, is now my father. I never spoke anything about this appointment till I got it, but I was briefing him as to what is happening. Within 5 days, all this happened, and all the 5 days he called me with so much of concern, personal concern as to what is happening to you. So what I want to convey to our young generation is, please understand who will support you till the last. You're all in lockdown. Everybody will agree it's only your family. And therefore, never compromise on your family interest. When I moved into marriage and with two children and one son-in-law now, and maybe in the next few years, a daughter-in-law in the family, ultimately, like any other Indian wife, a man can be sane, sensible, and little bit of selflessness in him. If these three qualities is achieved by a man, it happens only because of his wife. You should attribute it only to your wife. Nobody else can do this to us, because when we try to be successful in rest of our affairs, someone has to take the kick. It is invariably your wife and your children. So she has sacrificed everything for my growth. Said this in every platform, and I say this one more time. And it is the way an Indian wife does for her husband across. Coming to my children, they always know I have not given them much of time. In fact, you will be surprised if I say this information. In my 31 years of my professional life, I have not traveled with my family to any foreign destination. I have not moved out of India even once. So this is how I am. But they only know that whenever there's a need, my father will stand up for them. This is the assurance, emotional assurance I've given to them. When we say emotional quotient, it does not stop with only family. I would like my younger generation to have one aspect in mind. See, why did I say that you should not compliment me or thank me? Because it is not a success achieved by an individual. It doesn't happen that way. A string of people will come into your life. You wait and see. It'll happen to each one of you. It's going to happen. And go and read the biographies and go and see success people. It has happened to them. So ultimately, success happens because at every stage of life, somebody will be there to handhold you. I want to mention a few of them here. It's my duty. And to start, I'm leaving out my early stage of my life. I will start from my professional life, because that is important today for the children. So who are the people who helped me between 1989 and 2020? I should thank Muthu's father, Mr. Shankaran, my uncle, who first took me not to Mr. C. Natarajan. We went and met his elder brother, Mr. C. Venkatraman. And on seeing him, he took his visiting card, wrote on the backside to his brother, "Why don't you try this person? He looks to be a promising youngster." That was the passport which made me enter the portals of Sina Rajan Sir's office. And I was with him between 89 and 2003 and had the best tutelage, something I think nobody else would have had it in their life. Now, when I had to start on my own in 2003, Mr. A. Vijay Raghavan, who was then, he has worked for the government, he has appeared as an SDR and he has appeared for the SSC. He said, I will come and sit with you. And he gave me one assurance. I will sit in the office. I will not practice. I will not go out anywhere. You travel wherever you want to travel. If clients come, I will be ready to receive them. So it was he who ensured clients meeting happened without any interruption and allowed me to travel. At this juncture, I should also mention the trust and the help which Muthu Venkatraman, the lovable Muthu Venkatraman, each one of you know, has extended to me from 1996 till date and even thereafter. It was he who said, you go anywhere, I'll be here. And two more people, P. Purushottam, who took me, the moment I got designated, he was the first to take me to different high courts. And also I cannot forget the help of Mohammed Shafiq, who is now our AGP taxes. It was he who taught me VAT. In CNSR's office, I was doing only Central Excise and Customs. VAT was actually taught to me only by Mohammed Shafiq. When this was happening, the next phase of my life, Mr. V. Ranganathan, a former partner of Ernst & Young, came and invited me I should become an external counsel for EY. So between 2005 and 2009, 5 long years, I was an external counsel. It was he who took me out of Tamil Nadu and pitched me into the global, into the national map. And it was he who said, you can also do direct taxes. Come on, start doing direct taxes for EY. Next came in my life is Mr. P.V. Srinivasan, former vice president of IPRO and now the current tax advisor. He became my teacher in income tax. And the moment I came out of EY after 5 years of contract in 2009, he gave the high-pitched tax matters to be done by me in Karnataka High Court. As this was progressing in 2014-15, I landed up in knowing Dr. Vaidya. Then I admitted my son in Shastra University. And it was Vaidya sir who gave me the platform to speak in public on various subjects. And it was he who took me to S. Gurumurthy sir. I had seen Gurumurthy sir only in photograph. I've been reading his articles from 1983, but at one point of time, we started to share the same platform. And he started to invite me into his cabin and we started to discuss so many critical issues. And it was he who inspired me to think in terms of the nation. And when 3 important decisions were taken by the government, it was he who said, you should speak on all the 3 topics, Article 370, Ayodhya judgment, and also on CAE. It was he who said, you write a document. I said, I can't do it individually. So 4 juniors and 6 interns from Shastra, 11 of us, we prepared a 400 page document for him and gave it to him. And finally, in this came Ravi, who also gave me a platform to talk about CAA in a very, very important group of people. I have to mention 2 more people here. My interaction with Harish Salve in 2005. And my interaction with Justice Kota Raghuram for the past 10 years. We did what, how I became a senior is this. When we did the Bharti Airtel, I mean, this BSNL matter, reported judgment in March 2006. On the date of, I was briefing him for 4 weeks. On the date of conclusion of the argument, he said, come to my house. So I went to his home, he gave me a car. I didn't open the cover because I thought it may not be nice. He said, you open the cover, don't think it's a check. I've given you a more valuable gift. So when I opened, it was a letter addressed to the then Chief Justice of Madras High Court, Justice A.P. Shah, addressing a letter saying, please designate this young man. He deserves to be a senior. So that's how I got designated. And several other people, including retired judges, said that this is something which you should take it up. And then that is how it happened. And Justice Kota Raghuram gave me the taste for constitution. For 10 years, it was a delight to appear before his benches and learn. So this is a compendium who have brought me. What I want to convey to children is, please watch out. You must start witnessing your own life and you will start seeing people coming into your life and supporting you. When I got this appointment, imagine I have to thank the Madras bar, the whole of the Madras bar. Can you imagine? Parasaran sir, RK sir, DVR sir, PRR sir, Sriramulu sir, Ravindran sir, Sriram Panchu. Each one of them called me personally and blessed me. So, my dear children, Westerners think all these people who help you are only stepping stones. You have to use them as a ladder and climb up in life. Indians don't think that way. Our traditions don't permit to think that way. It is a bundle of these people who will make you your life worthwhile, interesting, and progressing. Never forget this. You can do this only when you have an emotional quotient in your life. Back to you, Natarajan.
Thank you, sir. You have connected the emotional quotient, not only with your family, but also a lot of people who had a great influence in your life and also gave the correct message to the youngsters. Now, if we move on a little further on that, we also know, in fact, I also had the opportunity, you can now see my background. That is the place where you are born, that Melmangalam village, where you have been conducting or running this particular Veda Padashala. And so many people have been undergoing the education, and it was a very good sight to go and see that particular. We ourselves get a different kind of a feeling when we visited that particular place. So this only signifies the role of various other institutions, like any other social institution you talked about, marriage, family and all. And similarly, the religious institutions, one may follow any religion, one may be a Hindu or a Christian or a Muslim or anything else. But the point here is, once you are devoted to your own religion on which you have the belief, you have to give something back to it. And the importance you give to such religious institutions is eminent from your this effort of running this Veda Padasala. Can you just share some of your experience? What prompted you to start this? How this has been going on? Can you just share something on that, sir?
Yeah, it has happened because of only two reasons. The grace, blessings and guidance by our guru, who said, this village had 60 pandits 60 years back. It came down to 3. And he said, it can't happen, therefore start it. So it is because of that, it was started again. And it is happening today because in 1981, my cousin became my friend, S. Vishwanathan. And for 4 decades, we have, what I think he will think and what he thinks it will reflect in me. We are a pair, inseparable pair. And both of us summoned by my guru and said, this will purify your mind. This will strengthen your character. This will enable you to move forward in life. Take this course and serve Sanatana Dharma. And that's how this Patashala has come again in the very same place, which it had some decades back. And I've always said this to my children and to anybody. Never, in fact, when we talk about the third section, I will deal with it one more time. Never think by becoming irreligious, you can become a good person. You can be a very good nature person, irrespective of whether you're religious or not. That has nothing to do with your good nature. But the right connects in your life can happen only when you respect divinity. Because you have no control over your birth. You have no control over your death. Whereas all of us think we have absolute control in the interregnum period. It is a misconception which Indian tradition does not accept. And therefore, please go back, as Nuts very clearly said, every religion teaches you to protect it. Our constitution says so. You have to profess, propagate and protect your religion. And do it with passion. Do it unless you respect your religion. How will you respect somebody's religion? Therefore, this is an indispensable step which each child should have in his life. Thanks, Natraj.
Yeah, when we are on emotional quotient, may I also request Mr. Vijay Kumar, who is a college mate of Mr. Venkatraman. I hope he is there. Mr. Vijay Kumar, to kindly join and share his experiences with Mr. Venkatraman. Mr. Vijay Kumar, you are there? Yeah, I think he's not there. Maybe in the meantime, somebody can send a message and keep him ready. I will call him later. So Hello. At this point, Hello. Yeah. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
My mic was muted. Yeah, thank you.
Okay.
Am I audible?
You are audible. Sir.
Congratulations, Bank Chairman, and thanks, Midwest Tax Board, for this wonderful opportunity. Actually, I'm inspired by that opening dialogue, and I'm a movie buff, of course, in Titanic. It's been 84 years. I can still smell the fresh paint. Like that, if I think back, I still remember the first day I met Venkatraman, 1983. And the next 5 years, we were sitting at the same bench next to each other. And the other day I remember is I come to Madurai railway station when he moves to Chennai for the first time. I come there on the first platform for Pandian Express. I tell him now I think it's silly of me. I tell him, go conquer Chennai. I couldn't think beyond Chennai at that time. So, and we all know the importance of the guru and partly thanks to Venkatraman, he keeps reminding us. And I wish not only CN sir, even my senior CV sir was here now, they would be so proud of this moment. And finally, I would say, not only hard work, the amount of sacrifice he has done. I remember the whole of his career, how much he has missed. And just a while ago, he was mentioning the time with his family, the kids when they were young, all this. But even as a friend, when somebody from your family becomes a public person, it's your responsibility. And this is something which you also have to sacrifice. So I hope I get we don't mind sacrificing the time, but so long we know that it is going for public good. Thank you, Venkatraman. It's a proud moment for me.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, Mr. Jayakumar. After covering two cues, that is that intelligent quotient and the emotional quotient, now we'll move on to the third quotient, that is the divine quotient. I have seen you as a personality who has been regularly giving various lectures and especially again targeted towards the youth. And what do you feel that the role of divinity in the success of a person, how important it is to follow the path of divinity, and what is your message on this, sir?
I'm not saying this. I would request all our children to go and read Palkiwala. One of the most successful counsel we have ever seen in our lifetime. He has said this. Life sans divinity is purposeless, senseless. So when we believe Naniji for everything, we should believe Naniji even for this. And let me put it in, I don't want to make this into a discourse because I want our children to understand what Natarajan is trying to ask, and we should address Natarajan's question. Do we need divinity? Can we not be successful without divinity? You can be successful. Who said not? Material success, you can be without divinity. Many have achieved it. But there is a difference. The difference is, we were talking in the previous section about emotional quotient. See, unless there are two aspects at a constitutional level and at a personal level. You will recognize and observe the difference between intelligent quotient and emotional quotient only when you have divine quotient in you. Otherwise, you will merge both into intelligent quotient. That's the first big mistake anyone can make if they don't appreciate divinity as part of their life. Now, two, when we say divinity, please understand, it is often confused saying that divinity is an anti-secular subject under the Constitution. Please don't believe it. It's a myth. Never told that school of thought. If somebody says, by being divine, by respecting divinity, by being religious, you are an anti-secular person, please don't believe it. Because, as I said, unless you love you and respect your religion, how will you love somebody who is religious? Somebody who respects his religion. And please understand this is the framework in which you have to operate as young children. Whatever is the family practice, whatever are the traditions that is followed, please follow it in your house. That gives you the comfort to move or toe with past practices. The moment you wear your shoes and put your coat and gown and walk out of your house, then Constitution demands you to respect everybody alike. There can be no gender bias, there can be no caste bias, and there can be no religious bias. So understand, you must wear two hats. When you are in your house, you are entitled to practice your divinity. When you step out, then it's a material world. Treat everyone alike. Respect each other's religious. You can still be engaged in a religious discourse because Constitution permits you, but respect the other person's point of view. And finally, you need to have this DQ because divinity makes you noble. Divinity makes you humble. Divinity makes you to think of gratitude. And divinity will make you to think of indebtedness because you are surrendering your ego to a higher spiritual force. When your mind surrenders that, you will surrender that also with your co-equals or more equals and feel indebted, feel gratitude. This comes only through divine quotient. And as children, I request you to kindly practice it. Natraj.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. Before I move on to the last cue, may I call upon one of the recent juniors of NV, Mr. Aryaman Gulati, to kindly join and share his experience about his senior and his guru. Aryaman?
Good evening, sir.
Hey, Aryaman. Happy.
So I would firstly like to thank MTV for giving me the opportunity to share a few words about my senior and my revered senior. The first time I met sir was during my first internship. I think back in 2017, I had interned under sir and I had a wonderful experience with the intense exposure to law. And by God's grace, 2-3 years down the line, I find myself working and assisting sir. And every interaction you have with sir, there is always a takeaway and you will always learn something of legal knowledge, but not just that, there will always be some sort of life lesson you'll take back or like a spiritual learning. So my interactions with have been extremely fruitful for me, not only on the legal front, but on the spiritual. And I've learned a lot about life and how one ought to live. And the sure values you're exposed to when you have an interaction with you, sir, is extremely, I'm extremely grateful, sir.
Thank you, Aryaman.
Now, the last quotient is going to be the spiritual quotient. After the IQ, EQ, and DQ, now we will move on to the spiritual quotient. We have always seen you respecting not only your professional guru, but also the spiritual gurus, and you have been giving lot of lectures on that particular aspect of life, that is the spiritual quotient. And what is the connect between the divine quotient and the spiritual quotient? Spiritual quotient may be a subset of a divine quotient. So how does it helps again in the profession or in the life of the people, the importance of spiritual quotient in one's life? Can you please share, sir?
I'm very happy you asked this question, Natraj. See, we have been taught one basic lesson at a very, very young age in our life. Mata, Pita, Guru, Devam. And I think after traveling into life for 54 years, I think that is the only lesson we need to learn in our life. We don't have to learn anything else. If we learn this first lesson, which is the only lesson properly, then everything will fall into place. I'll tell you why. I'm making again this request to our young children. Please bear this aspect in your mind. See, when you reach 50, 50 plus, many good things will start happening in your lives. Like the one which all our friends are now greeting. But at that point of time, invariably, invariably. You will miss your parents. They may not be there to see you and be with you and share that moment of joy. My request, therefore, is to the children, please take care of your parents when they are alive. Don't miss that opportunity. You will never get it again. And we will know them and their value only when they depart from us and not before us. See, three people are very important to me before I go to my guru. My father was a retired income tax officer. He retired in 1984 and died in 2018 at the age of 93. One Mr. C.V.S. Manian, who is an auditor even today at Madurai, who is 80 years old, writes to me even 3 months back and writes to me after this appointment saying, "What do you know what has brought you here? Your father's honesty and integrity. And your father has lived like a karma yogi in the income tax department." So this is the moral which my father has imparted to me. When it came to my mother, she died on July 8th, 2008. Until July 7th, the previous day, she was quite active. And she imparted the invaluable knowledge of prayers. She will pray for hours together every day. And she'll pray for every of her relative in life. Prayer, bhakti, and hard work. She will start her day at 4:45, which any Indian woman will do, and go on till 11:15. And it goes on 365 days for every mother in Indian family. She's one such mother who has inspired me. And three, my late brother, Mr. Sundar Rajan, who died at the age of 32 in 1984. See, he had a congenital heart problem, which we couldn't rectify at that point of time. We neither had advanced medical science nor the resources to treat him. So doctors said he may die any day from his 15th year. And remember, he lived for 17 years. Every day he was walking into death. But till he died, he lived a beautiful life. He worked hard. He earned promotions. And he would say, "Yeah, I'm going to die, but why should I bother about it?" So the moral I carry, which I've been carrying, which is very relevant today in this appointment, is all of you are greeting me. So thousands of people have wished me, but still, I've still not performed anything. That's why I was hesitant to take this felicitation. Unless you do something, how can you be felicitated? Anyhow, I convert this into blessings and good wishes. But working in a big public institution, one can succeed and one can equally fail. It's like a rocket launch. The rocket, when you launch, strikes sometimes and it also falls flat. So we don't know what is in store. I have taken this from my brother. I don't know what is in store, but I will still walk into it very sincerely with dedication. And when all of you expect so much that this fellow may perform something, I only wish and pray I should not belay your hopes. So I take the blessings of my father, mother, and my brother. And 2 minutes on my guru, I have to speak about it. It is my professional guru has given me professional life. My spiritual guru has given me spiritual, my very life. I should have died in a road accident on 14th February 1996. I was saved from the accident. And when I went and stood before him, even before I could address him, he said, "Your life was saved for a purpose, and therefore do that purpose." I didn't speak a word. He said this to me, and he gave me life. And this is what he conveyed to me on this appointment. Uphold Dharma. And made the message very loud and clear. You can uphold Dharma only when you give up ego, anger, aggression, and hatred. You may be doing dharma, but if you do it with ego, your dharma will not work. If you do it with hatred, your dharma will not work. So do dharma, giving up all the four. That's the message he has conveyed it to me. And two, the message he has conveyed to the nation, because we are all in a COVID situation. This is what our guru has said to us. Don't bother. India need not bother about it much. And the land of Dharma, one who performs Dharma, need not bother about it. And he gave this example. It's like a rubber ball. When you put it on the ground, it goes, pitches on the ground and comes back quickly. In contrast to a mud ball, when you throw the mud ball, it just falls flat on the floor. One who practices Dharma, problems will come to everybody. Nobody is an exception. It'll come to nations, it'll come to kingdoms, it'll come to families, it'll come to individuals. But if you stay on course with Dharma, it's like a rubber ball. As it goes, as it comes into our life, it'll also go back in the same speed. But if you're not on the side of Dharma, then it's like a mud ball. You'll get stuck somewhere in life. And the third last aspect, which I wish and pray to my guru is, he has always said, a guru protects his sishya in three ways. A hen hatches the egg and sits over it to hatch its chicken. A fish lays the eggs in the water and sees the eggs and ensures that its child comes out. A tortoise lays the eggs on the shore, comes into the ocean and keeps remembering the eggs which it has laid and ensure that a child tortoise comes out of it. So a guru has three powers. He can emancipate somebody through a touch. He can emancipate somebody through a sight, and he can help somebody and protect somebody through his remembrance. I'm now going to Delhi. I was traveling 6-7 times. When people say, where do you go for holiday? Don't you go to a hill station? I always say, I go to Western Ghats. Shingeri is in Western Ghats, and I visit 7 times a year at least. So I'm not going to do that frequently. I only wish and pray. If my guru protects me, applying the tortoise rule of remembering me, then this assignment, I'll be able to discharge the best of my ability. And I request all our children, go back to two basics. Go back to your Kula Guru and go back to your Kula Devam. Unless you worship your Kula Guru and your Kula Devam, worshipping anybody else is not going to yield you any result. And this is the foundation of our Indian value system. Follow this and you will be ultimately, see, remember, we can be successful. We need not be successful. It's not in our hands. Each one is designed for something, but we must be peaceful. We must be happy. That is common to the human race. Peace and happiness is achievable by everybody. There is no exception. There is no caste bar. There is no color bar. There is no religion bar. There is no sex bar. Each one is entitled to peace and happiness. And it can happen only when you have IQ, EQ, DQ, SQ, intelligent quotient, emotional quotient, divine quotient, and spiritual quotient. I only pray one request to MTB, having stayed with me all along and continue to stay with me. Please keep me in your prayers, because it is prayers which protect human race. I once again bow down before people who are elders to me, because it is COVID time. Otherwise, I would have visited each one of you. I bow down and take your ashirvadam. And people who are younger to me, please keep wishing me. Thank you, Jay. Thank you, APS. And thank you, Nataraj, for making this section very, very meaningful.
Thank you, sir. As you see this slide, you are an embodiment of all the four Qs. You are an embodiment of all the four Qs. Now, before I call upon the last speaker of the day, in fact, from our side, or rather from my side, we also have a small message to you. Just a minute. I'll just do the last screen. Last screen, I will just share. And incidentally, whatever you spoke just now has been there in my slide also. To quote from Bhagavad Gita, what is said there is, do not fight with hatred, but fight for justice.
fight with equanimity. So long as you are with us, and now you are going to the opposite side. And definitely we know that it is not an opposite side. And you will always stand by Dharma with equanimity, wherever justice demands, even though we all know that you may have a lot of pressures in the post and all that. But we definitely hope that whenever you feel, even if the government is wrong, you will have the wherewithal, you will have the courage to say that that particular course is not proper and we have to help the citizens in this particular way. So, and with this message, and now I call upon the last speaker of the day, Jay Kumar. JK?
Sir, very good evening. Am I audible?
You are audible, JK.
Thank you, sir. Natarajan very vividly brought out the four intelligent, emotional, divine and spiritual quotients. I am just trying to touch upon something called charisma quotient for you, but not in a very positive way. You have to excuse me because I am going to touch it upon with my own confession. In fact, I believe commission can be in camera, but confession should be public. So I'm coming out with this, sir. With your permit, I would request you to permit me to go for a confession.
Please.
Thank you, sir. So lovely. Sir, actually, in the session which we had with the legends, where you spoke about CN also, in that, when I introduced you, I gave a small account of how I am impressed or how my path to this profession was led by you and everything. But I didn't tell that there is a part one of that story. I only said about the part two of the story. In a very brief account, I would say, actually, the day I left that office, after listening to you, I was completely against you. Because I came with a lot of hope that I'm going to book a case, and when I was going back, I was empty-handed. And as an officer, it is a very natural reaction for me that I had enormous hatred against a person who is on the opposite side, who is trying to convince me. In fact, when I chose this profession and I just came out also, if you had three great rivals, or if you have three persons, if you have a list, I don't know whether you have a list. If you have a list of top three haters about you, you could have counted one on me. I, in fact, hated you. Thereafter, I have to tell this absolutely from the bottom of my heart. And thereafter, because in the profession, you were my competitor and you were, I couldn't go anywhere near because everywhere I saw you. So naturally, it multiplied, compounded. And I have to, many people may feel shy to talk about this, but I have to tell you this. After your exit from CN's office, I even loathed you. The hatred, I have to tell you, the hatred graduated. I started loathing you. And I always felt that you were a bad person. I have to say this. Then, when you became a senior, one of my clients forced me to engage you. That is why I came to your office that day. I think it should be somewhere in 2006 you became a senior. And somewhere in 2007 or so, he insisted. And I can't lose that client. So that is where I stepped into your office. Otherwise, I would not have stepped into your office at all. But that day, when I came to your office, Muthu was, he was the one who was taking me to your cabin. The first picture on the staircase I saw, fine portrait of senior advocate C. Natarajan. That very moment, nothing, great transformation happened to me. But there was a small, I would say, there is a ripple. Just I thought that why he is having it, and it was completely a new thing to me. I came to you and I spoke and we discussed the case. As Aparna Madam very rightly said, you gave such a wonderful audience. Natarajan also said that you give a wonderful conference. After that, we went back. And second, very important, only four things I want to say, which why I'm talking to you right now. The second point is the client called me again and I told him that I was indisposed And so I told him, you go and meet him directly. Then he took came for an appointment with you, and he came back to me and said, Senior N. Venkatraman denied to meet me. He said he will meet only through Jay Kumar. Absolute integrity. I would not have done that, sir. I would not have done that. That was the second instance, which was a very important milestone for me in my internal transformation. I started looking up. He's not that bad as I was thinking. That was the second, progression. Then the third very important thing is, with Muthu and Co, we went for a tour. In fact, it was all for a tax bar tour to Kodaikanal. En route, we went to Melmangalam. There, as Natarajan rightly said, we witnessed. I was a first-hand witness to what was happening there. Leave alone the religion, leave alone anything, religion, etc., etc. I saw a very noble effort happening there. And the machinery was working like with such an ability. So many young guys, young kids, grooming with such, there was an aura, I would say. That entire place, on one end, there was a temple, and at the road end, you had your, still it is very vivid to me. And there was an aura. This made me to complete, switch the wall. I moved from this side of the wall. Yet I'm not a fan of yours, I'm telling you. But this is the third very important construction, this progression. Last one was, Natarajan rightly accounted, on March, I believe it is March 2016, where you had a Guru Vandanam for your senior. And I didn't come for that. I thought, this is not right if I go, because I am feeling another way. Then I watched it in YouTube. Sir, trust me, I have an antenna. If I can sense bad, I could also sense good. And I have the blessings of my parents in that way to identify between the good and bad. I may choose to toe the good or bad, but I have that antenna with me. After watching that video, I'm telling you, Mr. Venkatraman, Senior Advocate, Additional Solicitor General of India, I have become a die-hard fan of you, because the truth struck me. No professor, nothing, no Vedic, nothing discourse could have changed to Jay Kumar. But the pure truth of yours struck me like a dart, pierced me inside, blasted the wall, and made to see the other side, the real side of you. From that moment till date, thereafter I saw that my exit plan was on that your table. Then I thought, I want to connect that kallai paatha kadula paak mudiyadhanu oru arumiyana paattu irukilla disavadharathile. Till such time I was seeing only that, and I couldn't see anything. I was seeing only as a stone. I was only seeing the dark. And thereafter I started seeing the light. And the light grew more intense. And I am absolutely floored. I have to honestly confess that. It is not even charisma quotient. Now I can even upgrade it. I would say there was a real truthful aura, which was backed up by truth in you, which changed me. I wanted to put it in public, and I chose this day for that. And I have to say this from the bottom of my heart, leave alone everybody can have their own impressions. You are the true Sishya of your Guru, both professionally and spiritually. And I bow down to you, sir, and thanks a lot for making me to wake up to the real truth. Thank you, sir. That was my echo to you.
Thank you so much for the kind words, JK.
Confession.
I'm proud that you spoke what you had in your mind.
Thank you. Thanks for allowing me to do that.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. JK, can you just break the mood? We are all highly charged now after your confession. And you take the responsibility to break the mood into a little lighter mood also. Why don't you?
I would prefer Dhoni to do that. I always go to Dhoni for that. Because even I am totally charged. I need something to know. I mean, to offload. Or unwind. Unwind me and unwind the session, please, ABS. Over to you.
Of course, I also wanted to say something.
Yeah, please.
One of Mr. Senior Advocate, Mr. N. Venkatraman's classmate is relative.
ABS, the sound is not audible.
Mr. N. Venkatraman's classmate is relative to me. So he has given some inputs. Regularly, he sends inputs about the senior. So he is a great singer and as well as a dancer also. And in fact, I only posted that video.
You got it right.
for his daughter's marriage, he danced. I think I posted that video in the group. So I think to make the moment lighter, I'll invite Mr. N. Venkatraman sir to sing some song. So I will give some clue for that also. So as correctly stated in tax scam, you have appeared in all the 23 high courts and as well as the Supreme Court. It's like Bharatham Sutriya Valiban. Of course, you said you have not traveled beyond India. You have not crossed the sea barriers of India. So I think it would be a fitting to sing any song from the film Ulagam Sutrum Valiban, sir. Of course, Bharat is the world for us.
Oh my God.
Yes, sir.
I hope it doesn't become an anti-climax. I thought I will also break a hard moment into a lighter moment when a lot of people called me to say, sir, what are you now going to do for our cases? So I have one standard stock answer. Don't worry, nothing will happen in India in 3 years. I'll come and do it. So now, anyhow, even though we love so many people, whom I love the most is my wife. But for her, I am nobody. Okay, at a material level, in the worldly level. So I will sing 6 lines thinking about her. Okay. So pardon me if it's not going to be so musical. In fact, Dr. Kothari played such a nice music that day. So flawless it was. I can't do to that perfection, but I'll still. Maragada malar veedum poongodi malalai koovum paingili Maragada malar veedum poongodi malalai koovum paingili இரவில் ஒளி தரும் மாணிக்கம் இரவில் ஒளி தரும் மாணிக்கம் என் நெஞ்சில் தந்தேன் ஓரிடம் அவள் ஒரு நவரச நாடகம் ஆனந்த கவிதை நாள் கழுவிடும் இனங்களில் மானினம் தமிழும் அவளும் ஓரூரு நவரச நாடகம் ஆனந்த கவிதை
விட்டுருக்கப்பா
இன்னும் முடியலையே சார்.
இல்ல இல்ல இல்ல,
கண்ணதாசன் எழுதின மிகச் சிறந்த பாடல்கள் அதுவும் ஒன்று. எம்எஸ்வி மியூசிக் வேற. இன்ஃபேக்ட் இது 1 இயர் நான் பிறகுறதுக்கு முன்னால வந்த படம் 1973ல
எஸ்
நாத ஃபேண்டாஸ்டிக் மேரி வேர் எம்ஜிஆர் டேக்கன் டு தி வேர்ல்ட் டூர் உலகம் சுற்று மாறி இருந்தது. ஐ திங்க் சிமிலர் டு கண்ணதாசன் வி ஆல்சோ ஹேவ் எ பாயட் இன் அவர் ரெபர்டரி. ஹி கேன் இன்ஸ்டன்ட்லி கேன் ரைட் எ கவிதை. சோ ஐ திங்க் ஹூ இஸ் நன்னல் அதர் தென் அவர் மிஸ்டர் ஜெயக்குமார் இஸ் தி ஜேம்ஸ் பாண்ட்.
ஒரு நிமிஷம் டைம் கொடுங்க. Just a second.
பட் அவர் கொடைக்கானலும் வேண்டாம் சுவிட்சர்லாந்தும் வேண்டாம், அவர் இப்ப இருக்கிற வீடே வந்து அதை விட பெட்டரா இருக்கும். அதனால அந்த வீட்டுல ஏதோ ஒரு இடத்துல மூடு வர்றதுக்காக போயிருக்காருன்னு
நினைக்கிறேன். எழுதிட்டு எழுதிட்டு ஒரு நிமிஷம் படிப்போம். படிக்கிற முடியும் நம்மள இந்த குரலை வச்சு நான் அவர் சார் சொன்ன மாதிரி ஆன்டி கிளைமாக்ஸ் ஆயிடும்.
விர்ச்சுவல் இமேஜ் மிரர் பண்ணணும், விரடா மிரர் எடுக்கணும்.
ஒரு நிமிஷம் ஒரு நிமிஷம் ஒரு நிமிஷம்
விர்ச்சுவல் இமேஜ் மிரர்
மிரர் இமேஜ் இது பண்ணணும். ஒன் செகண்ட். இது கரெக்டா இருக்கா?
இல்ல மிரர் இருக்கு.
ஆ மிரர் தான இருக்கு. சரி ஓகே நான் படிக்கிறேன் அது பெட்டர். ஒரு நிமிஷம் நான் படிக்கவா அத ஒரு வரிய. அதுல அந்த ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஸ்டான்ஸா வரும் குறுநகை அப்படின்னு ஒரு ஆரம்பிக்கும். அதை வந்து நான் எப்படி எழுதியிருக்கேனாக்கா சார் படிக்கலாமா வித் யுவர் பர்மிஷன்?
படிங்கப்பா.
குருவின் பாதத்தில் தாமரை உதவும் உள்ளத்தின் வான்மழை அறிவு சுடர்விடும் மாணிக்கம் எங்கள் நெஞ்சில் தந்தோம் ஓரிடம் அவரொரு நவரச நாடகம் ஆனந்த கவிதையின் தாயகம் புள்ளினத்தில் ஒரு கோகிலம் இனி தமிழும் ஹிந்தியும் ஓரிடம். சொல்லவா சார்?
வா 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 ஜெக்கி சார், நம்ம எம்டிபி குரூப்போட வாலி நீங்க தான் சார்.
வாலியா? ஏப்பா இப்பதானே அவர் சொன்னாரு அது கனாதாஸ் எழுதினதுன்னு. அதுவும் இல்ல இல்ல அதுவும் நீ கோத்து விடுற பத்தியா ராமன் எழுத்தாப்புல இருக்காரு அவர் முன்னால வாலிங்கிறேன்ன நான் சுக்ரீவனாவே இருக்கேன்பா.
ரைட் சார். சார் இது வந்து பாட்டா படிச்சா நல்லா இருக்கும். நம்ம குரூப்ல டிஎம்எஸ் முத்து சார் இந்த பாட்டு பாடுனா ஐ திங்க் இட் வில் பி எ ஃபிட்டிங் எனிவே.
வாவ் 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 முத்து சாரி டிஎம்எஸ்.
குருவின் பாதத்தில் தாமரை உதவும் உள்ளத்தில் வான்மழை குருவின் பாதத்தில் தாமரை உதவும் உள்ளத்தில் வான்மழை அறிவு சுடர் விடும் மாணிக்கம் அறிவு சுடர் விடும் மாணிக்கம் எங்கள் நெஞ்சில் தந்தோம் ஓரிடம் அவன் ஒரு நவரச நாடகம் ஆனந்த கவிதையின் தாயகம் அவன் ஒரு நவரச நாடகம் ஆனந்த கவிதையின் தாயகம் புள்ளினத்தில் ஒரு கோகிலம் தமிழும் ஹிந்தியும் ஓரினம் அவன் ஒரு நவரச நாடகம்.
தேங்க்யூ தேங்க்யூ டிஎம்எஸ் பின்னிட்டவா.
தேங்க்யூடா தேங்க்யூடா
thank you muthu thank you lovely lovely oh do you
APS and now we are on the last leg of the session. May I now request our APS Dhoni Valluvardhasan once again
to Bahubali.
Bahubali to say the formal vote of thanks.
Before that let me thank each one of you once again for spending more than 90 minutes for my sake, which is very, very valuable to each one of you. Thanks a lot. And whatever you have conveyed, I want to place it at the lotus feet of my spiritual guru and my professional guru. And may them guide and bless each one of us to reach great heights. And my dear children, do your very best. India gives you a lot of opportunity. Make a good, new, great India in your life. Thank you so much.
One more, sir. Mr. Envy, sir, we also received an audio clip from your sister. We wanted to play it as a surprise thing, but playing an audio clip in the Zoom platform, we tried that it was not happening. I will forward it to you in the WhatsApp.
Oh, thank you so much. Oh, I see.
Natarajan, sir, do you want to try using your other device once?
Just a minute. Let me try. One second.
I'll unmute other device also.
Yeah, just we will try once. One minute. Is it audible?
Illa.
No, sir.
Until we tried it, it didn't work.
Okay.
Yeah. Sir, we'll send it across to you.
Thank you.
Sir, you use your phone to play that audio and use the laptop mic to play it, sir, so that we can hear something at least from that.
One
minute.
You can mute your phone and play that audio in the laptop mic. It will come, sir.
Is it audible? No, then leave it.
Yeah.
Over to APS.
Yeah.
Sir, I thank you for accepting our invitation and for sharing your valuable time with us. It's our duty to have a felicitation to you. And of course, we all immediately assembled at the very earliest moment we were able to arrange. And you will be integrating the South India and North India. And already we said Tamilum, Indium, Orinam. So you'll be leaving to that. I'll conclude this with Valluvar's Thirukkural. Thondir pugalodu thondru, Athilar thondru, Thondraamin. They are fit example for that. Thirukkural, sir, will be with you and we all seek your blessings and we wish a good success to all your endeavors in life, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, one and all.
Thank you, sir.
Namaskaram.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, Prateep. Thank you.
Yes, thank you once again for all joining us. This has been one kind of a felicitation where we have got to learn a lot of new things in this felicitation by the man himself, Mr. N. Venkatraman, Senior Advocate and Additional Solicitor General for India. I think this is a fitting conclusion for time being of this webinar series. We will be coming back in few days now, but I think this was one of the very inspirational session for all of us. So thank you all for joining us today. This session will be put up in our YouTube channel as well. So, and I'm sure that this particular session can be shared with not only advocates, but any other professional for that matter. Because this is so inspiring and it has given so many qualities of learning from the man himself. Thank you so much all for joining us. Please take care of yourselves. Stay home and stay safe. Thank you and good evening.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, Nuts. Thank you, Nataraj. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.